number will be by Bob Durkos, Silent Night, guitar solo. While he's getting prepared, I'll just speak to you a little bit about Colossians. In verse 1, chapter 12, it says, "Give thanks unto the Father, which hath made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light, who hath delivered us from the power of darkness and hath translated." Do you hear that? What's that? That's past tense, isn't it? Yeah. "Translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son." In verse 14, it says, "In whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins." Verse 15, "Who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature." Does that bring you to another scripture? That takes me to Romans 8:29. What's Romans 8:29 say? "For whom he did foreknew," no, "he did also predestinate to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren." Among many brethren. Is that a promise? God said there's going to be more than one, right? Do you hear also in there John 14:6, where Jesus says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life"? He is the pattern. Paul calls him after the cross here, the firstborn of the dead.
Well, I have a historic story too, and maybe many of you have heard it before, but hopefully it was years ago and it'll make some new meaning to this song. It's back in 1818. Joseph Moore, a young priest from a small town of Obendorf in the Austrian Alps, was planning a Christmas program for months. But he realized a few days before the program that the organ wouldn't play. And he desperately worked on it, and he just couldn't come up with, he couldn't make it work. So in his desperation, needing music for the program, he went to his friend, actually the choir director of the church, Franz Gruber. He goes, "Franz, I can't make the organ work. Can you help me? Do you play any kind of instrument, anything?" And he said, "Well, I play a guitar." He said, "But I only know three chords. I'm a struggling guitar player." So he said, "Look," he said, here's a poem that I wrote 2 years ago. And please, take it home and see if you can put music to it." So he worked on that. "It's for tomorrow night," he said. The struggling guitar went home and composed this song with three chords. And it was a unanimous hit instantly. And within 20 years, King William IV of Prussia, it became his favorite song. And within 50 years, it was played at the, it was played in New York City, and it became America's most favorite Christmas carol, Silent Night, written and performed by a choir and a struggling guitar player. An amazing part of this story is that it was performed for the first time in 1888 on December 23rd. So that was 199 years ago to this day. Silent Night.
Home is bright. Song.